They took a wallet, packed up and did not set it. Milk Ishmael, no asoli could not eat though.
Milk Ishmael.
Clothe our true bridegroom. In your grace, make us and all the faithful departed worthy of your heavenly kingdom, that we may raise glory and thanks to you, to your Father and your Holy Spirit, forever.
Thank you. descend upon the reader and the listener, and upon the parish and her children forever.
Brothers and sisters, pray for us. We are sure that we have a clear conscience, desiring to act honorably in all things. I urge you all the more to do this, so that I may be restored to you very soon. Now may the God of peace, who brought back from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the eternal covenant, make you complete in everything good, so that you may do his will, working among us that which is pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom we be the glory forever. Amen. I appeal to you, brothers and sisters, bear with my word of exhortation, for I have written to you briefly. I want you to know that our brother Timothy has been set free, and if he comes in time, he will be with me when I see you. Those from Italy send you greetings. Grace be with all of you.
Praise be to God always.
And though there were so many, the net was not torn. Jesus said to them,
come and have breakfast. Now none of the disciples dared to ask him, who are you? Because they knew it was the Lord. Jesus came and took the bread and gave it to them. And he did the same with the fish. This was now the third time that Jesus appeared to the disciples after he was raised from the dead. This is the truth. Peace be with you.
Praise and blessings to Jesus Christ, our Lord.
TV show. course, Jesus doesn't do that, as far as I know. But they caught nothing. And what is it like to catch nothing at all and spend all night doing it? You know, they probably ripped each other and say, I thought you knew how to fish, and you said they would be here, and they're not there, and all kinds of things can happen in our life when things don't go the way we were hoping it to go. And there's a variety of ways to respond to it. You know, my brother, I'm not going to say his name, he broke his toe because he kicked his motorcycle because it wouldn't start. That's not good advice. But I was thinking about that net there. What if they had lost their temper and started just throwing it around, just threw it in the lake and it sunk to the bottom? Or what if they liked to tell fishermen stories and Jesus said, children, you have no fish, have you? Oh yeah, we caught a whole bunch of them, but they were not long enough, you know, the Lord was coming and we got caught, we had to throw them back in. There's always the fishermen's stories. But they said no. And I think that's highly symbolic because sometimes we don't want to admit when we feel empty inside. When it seems like we have just totally failed at what we're supposed to be able to do, be good fishermen. And with their emptiness, with their failure, they didn't hide it from Jesus. And I'm also thinking, if he's close enough where he can talk to them and he knows what they're saying, how come they didn't know who he was? I think that's very significant too, because so many times in our life, we have heard the right thing, but we didn't recognize it as the right thing. You know, I don't know if they were fishing on the left side and then arguing whoever got to convince them they tried the right side, or see, or other person started making fun of the other because, yeah, I told you should have done that. But all of these dynamics are in there because every day, in some way, we try to interpret our life, even in the little tiny things, that things don't go right. And in this case, they listened to him. And this was written by John, and I think that's fascinating too. And John puts in there, the disciple whom Jesus loved. You know, he wanted to make sure all of us knew that Jesus loved him. And he puts it right there in the gospel. And I think every single verse has several different meanings to it. But it all goes back to the same thing. That we don't always recognize Jesus. We might be able to quote verses backwards, forwards. We might be able to, when we judge, know exactly what verse to quote. We might have a very keen sense of many things religiously. But in all of that, can we recognize the kind of love that Jesus has for us and for the other person? That we do have to, and we filter everything through all kinds of experiences. And sometimes, in this situation, not only did they hear his voice and listen to it, they acted on it. Also in the scripture we find Peter taking a leadership role. You know, I'm thinking, Peter, you know, couldn't you have the other people bring in all that fish, you know? They were already on the boat, why go back out there? But Peter being Peter, he got right back on that boat and helped them bring it in. And he brought it to Jesus. And Jesus asked something of it from them. Bring some of the fish that you have just caught. So Simon brought it to him. And that's a reminder that we can be thankful for all the gifts that God's hand has been in our life. We're willing to give some of it to him. Not because Jesus would go hungry without it, but he's very much aware of the hunger that's in each side of us. That he identifies with each one of our hungers, whatever it might be. Is it righteousness? Is it justice? Is it tenderness? Is it forgiveness? Is it healing? He identifies with what's in you, and he identifies with what's in me, and he asks for the benefit of all of us. Jesus fixing breakfast. Now, as I said earlier, you know, if I were to be Jesus for a day, I would need a miracle to be able to fix a good breakfast for somebody else, you know. I use a very secret formula for breakfast. It's a bowl, milk, and cereal. And put it together inside the bowl. But I think you know exactly what I'm getting at. Don't allow yourself to be torn to pieces. Keep the net strong. Keep listening for the voice of the Savior, the one that has the power to fill our emptiness with the love that overflows. He doesn't break us. He heals us.
We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds. Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We confess our baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and we look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
I will go to the altar of God, to God. Hearts and souls, and with a holy kiss worthy of your blessed name,
that we may raise glory to you, to your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Peace to your holy altar of God, peace to the holy mysteries placed upon you, peace to you, all servers of the Holy Spirit.
Let each one of us give a greeting of peace to his neighbor with love and faith, which is pleasing to the Lord. Peace, David.
Sabakul mehneku kuhu.
Remember, O Lord, those who have presented presented these offerings upon the altar, and those who desire to do so but were unable. Grant them their petitions. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for all those who daily struggle with chronic illness, anxiety, and pain in their lives, that they will find healing and comfort in the Lord. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for peace throughout the world, especially in the Middle East, and an end to war and all acts of violence and hatred. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and a consecrated life to serve the Maronite Church. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember all the saints, the fathers, prophets, apostles, martyrs, and confessors, Mary, the Mother of God, St. Joseph, St. Jude, and St. Mary, and all the righteous and the just, through their prayers make us worthy to stand among them. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, in your grace, those who have left us and have gone to you a special friend. From the first Christian disciples to this day, they were signed with the seal of baptism and received the precious body and blood of your Son. They wait for you in life-giving hope. Raise them up on the last day, and in your mercy forgive their sins. To our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, who is without sin, we hope to find mercy and forgiveness for our sins and for theirs.
Grant rest, O God, to the departed, and forgive the sins we have committed, with or without full knowledge.
Grant us pardon, O God, and forgive us in the departed, so that your blessed name may be glorified in us and in all things, with the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, and that of your living Holy Spirit, now and forever.
As it was, is now, and shall be forever.
That with them we may raise glory to you and your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
mercy and compassion.
Holy gifts for the holy, with perfection, purity, and sanctity.
One holy Father, one holy Son, one holy Spirit, blessed be the name of the Lord, for he is one in heaven and on earth. To him be glory forever. Make us worthy, O Lord God, so that our bodies may be sanctified by your holy body, and our souls purified by your forgiving blood. May our communion be for the forgiveness of our sins and for new life. O Lord our God, to you be glory.
Thank you.
There is a Rosary Sodality meeting right after liturgy. And back at church is sign-up sheets to take an hour or so, if it's at all possible, to make sure there is somebody here present while we have the relics here. The sign-up sheet is right there in the back. Make sure you do that. Give some serious prayer to how many you can attend. Now, that doesn't mean we expect you to be here from 5:30 in the morning till 9:30 at night. But this gives a possibility for people who cannot make it during the day, they can come and say some prayers early in the morning before on their way to work or to the gym. And the later prayers are for those who get out of work a little late and they still have a chance to feel included. I'm sure all of you have someone special in your life that could certainly benefit from you spending time praying for them. Myself, I'm just going to just sleep over here and not bother to go anywhere but to the church, but I live here. But anyways, I do hope that you will take as much part of it as you can for the benefit of your own spirit and for certainly somebody else who is deeply troubled who could benefit from our intercessions for them. Gracious God and Father, how can we repay you for your goodness and for the salvation you've just given us? Who can give you the glory you truly deserve? In our weakness, insofar as we are able,